Hey, what's up, guys? Tom Fernandez here. And today, guys, I want to talk about what are the biggest concerns of people who are considering entrepreneurship. What are some of the biggest things that they're worried about? And then also at the end, I'll kind of share with you a little bit about what are some solutions for some of those concerns, because not all of the concerns are legit, and not all of the concerns apply to every business. So I wanted to break that down. I appreciate for those jumping on. If you're jumping on real quick, just type a comment. Just want to give you a shout out for jumping on tonight on this Thursday evening. I'm here in the office. We're getting some work done. Got a brand new agent that we're onboarding today, and I'm excited about that. But I quickly wanted to share some of the main concerns about what are some of the new people looking to get into business, looking to kind of do their own thing. What are some of the main concerns? So number one is abandoning their career. Most people are scared that they're gonna have to quit their job in order to go cold turkey and become an entrepreneur. So that's the number one concern. Number two is pretty obvious. It's financing. People now, people who want to start a business are wondering where they're going to get the capital in order for them to start a business. The average franchise costs 20, 30, 40, 50,000. Most people are wondering, okay, where am I going to get that? Am I going to have to take loans out? Am I going to have to take money out of my 401k? How am I going to fund my business? Number three is building a solid team building. Is building people around you that you trust, people around you that you know will work, and people that you can actually, have working alongside you with you day in and day out. Number four is decision making. I think we deal with that in our personal lives. Is, there's a big decisions as entrepreneurs, especially when you're starting your own business, that you're gonna have to make in order for you to see the success in your business. Some are big decisions. Number five, loneliness. A lot of entrepreneurs are what we call solopreneurs. They just work on their own. Some work from home via the internet. It can be lonely at times, especially if you're the only one who's an entrepreneur in your circle of friends and family. Number six is setting standards, setting the rules for your organization. When you build a business, you want it ran a specific way, and sometimes implementing those standards and those rules can be hard. You don't want to come off as a mean boss, but you also don't want to come off as soft and somebody who's a pushover. Number seven is afraid of the unknown. I think anytime we follow anything, it's just, what if? I don't know if I'm going to succeed. I don't know if I'm going to fail. And most people don't take that leap of faith just because they don't know what's going to happen. And then number eight, people are afraid of being the visionary. When you're looked at as a leader of an organization that you have to lead and run, that organization's success relies on your vision. And a lot of times people just, they're afraid that they're not going to have a big enough vision to take the company or to take whatever, they're looking to do far enough as an entrepreneur business owner. So what is the solution? Well, a lot of that, if not all of these concerns on this list that I mentioned, from abandoning career, financing, team building, decision making, can be solved. Most of these concerns are for people who are looking to go into an independent business, traditional kind of brick and mortar business. But a lot of times, what most people don't consider is starting their own franchise. So when you start your own franchise, number one, a lot of times is, for example, in my industry, I started off part-time. I still had other career things going on, so you don't have to leave or abandon your career. So that's a cool thing. Number two, typically when you start your own type of franchise or you basically start your business within a business, financing is pretty low. An example of that, it cost me $199 to get started in my business, plus whatever license I needed. Less than $500, I was able to start my business, here in the financial service industry. So a lot of times when you build a business within a business or you franchise, very low startup cost. Number three is team building. The hardest part about, building a business is finding the right people. But if you had a blueprint where somebody handed you and said, this is where you look for people, this is what you're looking for, and this is how you onboard those people, then it becomes easier, like a system. You're gonna hear me say this a few times throughout the video, but one of the biggest things about franchises like McDonald's and just all the franchises that you guys know of is they provide a duplicatable systems. Systems allow ordinary people to do extraordinary things, right? Number four is decision making. The good thing about having an already kind of built franchise or business within a business is a lot of the hard decisions you don't have to deal with. For example, in my industry, if I were to build my independent financial marketing organization, there's a lot of decisions on you know, what companies, and I got to sit in a boardroom with some of these big companies. Well, I don't have to do that because the business that I'm in, is that's already done on the back end for me. All I got to do is plug in and turn the key. You know, they call it a turnkey solution in business. Number five, loneliness. So the cool thing is, the type of model, when whenever you're with a business within a business or a franchise, is you're in business for yourself, but not by yourself. So I work in an office where I plug in with other agents. And the cool thing about that is we get to feed off each other. We get to help each other out. If they know something that I don't know, they help me out. If I don't know something, they help me out. We run appointments. So I got 200-300 agents working out of my office, all independent entrepreneurs and business owners. But we all help each other out and create an environment where we support each other. So there's no loneliness involved when you're building a business within a business. Number six is setting standards. So like I mentioned earlier, the type of business, when you build a business within a business, it has a system. When you plug into that system, a lot of the standards, a lot of the things are already built. So you don't have to recreate or reinvent the wheel, as they say. So you're just building a business that already has a set of standards, a set of rules to apply. You're just picking it up and you're just turning the key. It's a turnkey solution. Number seven, afraid of the unknown. This one's never avoidable. Whenever you take a leap of faith, whenever you start a business, whatever it is, you're looking to be an actor, whatever it is, especially in business, there is a afraid of the unknown. And what I tell people is, you know, anything that is worthwhile will involve a little bit of discomfort, will involve a little bit of nerves, will involve a little bit of scariness. But what will ease that is having a mentor, somebody who's been down the path. So if you were to travel from here to Texas driving on your own, it would be a little scary if you didn't have a map, if you didn't have a GPS, if you didn't know where you were going, you had to figure that out on your own. Well, the good thing about being in business for yourself but not by yourself is you have people who've been there, people who are making money, you know, in the industry, people who've been through the trenches, who can provide you those GPS kind of, you know, directions to get to where you need to go. Is it still fear of the unknown? Of course, you're starting a business. There's a lot of you know, risk involved, but at least you have somebody along the way where you can process issues with, and somebody to help you get from point A to point B. And then last but not least, is people are scared to become a visionary. And one of the things that I will tell you about becoming a visionary is it mostly involves the internal you. And nobody can give you a vision. They can just help you and guide you on what a vision is. But finding a vision for you is really finding out what do you want out of life. So for you, for those of you who are scared of becoming a visionary or saying, I don't have a vision, what do you want out of life? You have to internalize that. Spend some time alone figuring out, in prayer, in meditation, what is it exactly do I want? And number two is, how do I want to impact other people? And that can help shape your vision. But the most important three is tip number three. Creating that vision is really just going out there. And along the way, it's going to be more clear. You know, when I first got in business, I said, I want to get in business because, you know, I feel like there's not too many people from my demographic in business and I want to represent. Well, now that turned into, I wanted to get into business because I want to create programs where there are young kids who come from the inner city like me, who come from, you know, violent communities, who lost friends, who lost, you know, relatives, or who grew up in a gang infested area. I want to show them a solution other than sports and entrepreneurship. So I want to build programs where these young men can come and learn the four pillars that I believe. Number one, personal development. Number two, career development, fitness. And then number four, just finding that spiritual guidance. I believe those are the four pillars that helped me, that I found within entrepreneurship. And I want to package that up and provide the community with that. So with that being said, if you have any questions, if you're this person who has many concerns about becoming an entrepreneur, business owner, but you don't have guidance and you don't even know about building your own business within a business, feel free to reach out to me, let's connect, have coffee, and I can kind of guide you on what is it that you're looking to do, and maybe I can provide a solution for you. So as always, your success is important to you guys. I'll see you guys out there on the field.